The green flag waves at the back, and Moto2 is go in 2022 here in Spielberg. Superb launch from pole by Ayagura. Surely he's going to get the whole shot as they climb up the hill into turn one for the first time. Fernandez has been very aggressive as well to get through on Alonso Lopez on the brakes too. So Fernandez pinches second place quickly.
Oh, there was contact there twice on the run down to the first chicane between Acosta and Chantra as Lopez gets busy up the inside of Augusto Fernandez. Celestino Vietti is in that danger zone, and there's a crash at the back.
Yeah, there was a bit of drama further back. I think that might be Kubo, certainly one of the riders is involved. Nobody went down, but there was contact that put two riders into the escape road. That's Jake Dixon. That's aggressive. He picks up world championship leader Augusto Fernandez on that tricky braking zone uphill into turn three. That's cost Augusto Fernandez crucial places and a lot of time. In fact, Acosta has come through, and Vietti might do as well. Agüero leads, Chanter on the podium places in third. Sam is in between those two.
Lopez,
Lopez has gone for it. Now then, for the third race in succession then, after leading at the Dutch TT in Assen, he led for so long, didn't he, at the British Grand Prix in Silverstone. This is now three races on the spin that Alonso Lopez has hit the front. He leads on lap two here in Austria.
I wonder whether Agüero made a mistake coming through turns seven and eight, because he had a lead of nearly half a second at the end of the second sector, but it had suddenly closed right down as they approached turn nine, and it put Lopez right on the back of the pole sitter. And Alonso Lopez, as you say, he's no stranger to leading Moto2 Grand Prix nowadays, so he's going to be difficult to shift from the front of this field.
Oh, Alonso Lopez has made a mistake down there into turn number four. That's an easy mistake to make. One of the harshest braking zones, not just here in Austria, but on the entire World Championship calendar. So Agüero says thank you very much. Sweeps back into the lead with little effort. Just that little mistake by Alonso Lopez ran him off the optimal racing line through turns four and five. Just behind Fernandez in eighth place, rounding out your top ten at the moment is Schrotter and Aldegar. Then you've got Arbolino, Reynas, Bobier, Navarro and Dalla Porta in the point scoring places. Quick check on Sam Lowes's injury placement. The impressive Aussie teenager, Senna Agius, he's having an excellent ride in 20th right now. He's got some experienced men behind him, including a former Moto2 winner this season, Joe Roberts, having a bit of a nightmare weekend. He's 22nd. Multiple Moto3 race winner Nico Antelli also behind Agius. What a ride by the Aussie so far.
Yeah, it's been a difficult start to this Grand Prix as well for the Italtrans team, because Dalla Porta has gone down four places to 14th on the first lap of the Grand Prix. Fastest lap of the race, though, to the rookie Pedro Acosta, despite Celestino Vietti swarming over the back of him. The rookie is the fastest man on track.
I think Vietti has got through. They lean on each other now. Oh, it's a little bit unsettled, isn't it? Acosta, it got the inside line back through on Vietti for that downhill sweep through turn six. It was all out of shape. And Vietti does finally make a clean move through to take fifth. Chantra was well out of shape there, and he just somehow manages to pull it up on the brakes. There was contact there. You can understand why Lopez is really frustrated, because it was elbow to elbow, shoulder to shoulder. They were rubbing each other there. Chantra's mistake, he was so fortunate not to take the pair of them down. I'm still actually not quite sure how Chantra stayed up right there. Let's have a look at this from the helicopter shot. He picks up some slipstream, moves out alongside Lopez on the brakes, and then it just went wrong. They clearly had contact, didn't they?
Yeah, certainly wasn't any intent there from Chantra. Clearly got a little bit unsettled on the way in. We've got yellow flags out in sectors two and three. We'll confirm who's brought those out in a moment. But we now have an Inebitsu Honda Team Asia at 1-2. It's Sean Dillon Kelly, unfortunately, one of the three American racing riders in the field. He's gone down at turn four.
Not quite close enough. Oh, no, Dixon's run straight on. Dixon then has made a mistake at the top of the hill into turn number three. Comes out just in front of world championship leader Augusto Fernandez, who's just been kind of marooned, stuck in that P8 right from the first lap.
Back in the 134s, 34.5 last time round, which is quicker than the leaders.
Well, if you chuck the checkered flag out now,
Lopez
has gone around a couple of laps now. He's made mistakes down the hill into turn number four. And when Agüero passed him for the lead this time around, he slips off the podium places. Now it's Vietti who comes through. He's been pressurising Lopez into that mistake. It's an easy mistake to make in such an aggressive braking zone for that turn four. But Vietti then finally gets himself up into P3. Lopez, though, trying to use that different line he can run on the Bosca Scura, maybe to fight back through on the brakes down into turn number nine. We're on the helicopter shot. It's Vietti, Lopez, Acosta still right in this podium battle as well.
Acosta goes way wide, it suckered Lopez in, and it's now created a four-way charge towards turn three. This might be the opportunity that Fernandez has been waiting for.
Oh, he leans on Lopez. Lopez caught in a Fernandez Kinect sandwich there, wasn't it, at the top of the hill into turn number three. Great drama here off the podium battle between this five involving Acosta, Lopez, Kenneth Fernandez and Jake Dixon. It's Acosta that comes out the better of it. Actually, it was his mistake coming out of 2B that created all the chaos and carnage up at turn number five. Thankfully, they all came through it and Acosta still holds on to fourth. Chantra's got the inside line there. He cut it tight. Oh, careful there. Vietti was getting really loose. Was he on the front end of that Mooney VR46 machine then? Now, can he pick up the drive to attack Chantra on the brakes in the turn three? I just think that little
mistake. Oh, he's down!
Can you believe it? Celestino Vietti makes another massive blunder in this 2022 Moto2 World Championship up at the top of the hill, the highest point of this Red Bull Ring circuit. Here comes Aiguera then, on the last lap, turn four, all safely done then for the Japanese rider. What a day, what a weekend it's been for Aiguera. Just the second pole position of his Moto2 career yesterday. He made the dream launch from pole position. He briefly lost that lead to the fast-starting Alonso Lopez, but some Kiat Chantra, you just know he's just going to sit tight. Oh, here comes Fernandez. And was that Pedro Acosta?
It's Acosta.
Yeah, it was Acosta who really badly wants that podium finish on his return from major injury. Down the hill, though, they come. Somkiat Chantra. Hang on a minute. What's going on here? Somkiat Chantra has gone through an Aiguera. He said P2 okay. What is going on here? Here comes Aiguera. Then they attack through here. I can't believe what I'm seeing here. There was clear team orders for Chantra to say P2 okay. He went for it. Aiguera will win the Austrian Grand Prix Moto 2 in 2022.
Oh, Dixon's
Pedro
got it.
Acosta has lost the podium right at the end. Great job by Jake Dixon. He comes over the line then to take a hard-fought third place.
And a victory for Aiguera as FIM President George Viegas gives a hug to Jake Dixon in third place and a shake of the hands for Aiguera, who will surely be a MotoGP one day, even if it isn't this season, as Aiguera takes victory and the lead in the Moto2 World Championship.